What's up, YouTube? Tops85401 here. I'm going to do a recap of a card show I went to on Saturday with my friend Eric, aka Big Mac Fanatic. We had a blast. So much fun. We actually uploaded a quick little live video at the show on the other channel, Baseball Card Junkies TV. Pick this up. There is a gentleman by the name of Jim, and I run into him at shows. Usually about half the time I go to the show, he's there. And sometimes he'll bring items that he thinks I might need. And he brought this, and it turns out I didn't have it. Great piece here. Barry Bonds, Matt Williams. I love it. We were talking about how it has like the Coca-Cola logo. And Jim was telling me that he thought this was something that was given away at a movie theater, which makes a lot of sense. But we got the Orange and Black Giants Kids Club, Barry Bonds National League MVP, Matt Williams, Gold Glove third baseman. So beautiful piece there for the Giants collection. I don't consider that a card. However, I do like items like that that are kind of like multi collectible. You got Matt Williams, Barry Bonds, Coca-Cola, just a great piece. So glad to add that to the collection. Now I'll show off the cards I bought. Starting off, I got a nice Topps Tiffany, 87 Topps Tiffany Barry Bonds. And some observations I made at the show. It seemed like it was pretty collector heavy. There were the typical, you know, Pelican cases opening and, you know, high dollar cards being traded, but a lot of just pure collectors were there as well. And that was good to see. And so I'm going to show off some cards I purchased. I spent a total of $1,000. My intent was to spend $400 or less, but guys, you know how that goes at shows. This was my first kind of semi-big pickup, I guess you could say. It's a Barry Bonds autograph card from 2000 Pacific Revolution. Not my favorite Bonds auto, but one that I didn't have. Obviously, that would probably, you know, let you know. It was not my favorite Bonds auto because I didn't have it. But I picked it up. The price is right. Picked up this Pudge Rodriguez. There were several tables that had the sweet spot, Golden Age of inserts, stuff I really, really enjoy. Got this out of a value box from one of those dealers. It's numbered 1 of 10, Pudge Rodriguez. Love that card right there. I'm going to save the best for last, guys, because the last card I'm going to show, I am just absolutely pretty pumped up about. So let me get all my card show pickups. I'll try to go quick. Got a few rookie cards. Let's start off with the rookies. I got this Don Mattingly, 84 Fleer. Been wanting a copy of that crier. Have one. It's off-centered left to right. This one I got off-centered top to bottom, but like that card. Can never have enough of these. 86 Sport Flicks. A Manny Machado. Logan Webb. First Bowman. Love that card. Got our nice Ronald Acuna, first Bowman, a Vladimir Guerrero, red parallel, and Juan Soto, Topps Heritage, along with a pre-rookie Bowman color variation. So those are cool. I got to tell you a story about one of the dealers. I had a really cool conversation with one of the dealers. And when I find a card that I bought from his table, I'll kind of talk about that a little. Here's a cool card, an 88 Topps Tiffany McGuire. Thought this card was cool. I got this for $1. You got Cabrera, Maurer, and Trout. All three of these guys will end up in the Hall of Fame. And that's I think it's a Walmart blue parallel. Thunder Boomers. There we go. I got a grip of just decent inserts. Piazza, Ricky Henderson. This one's numbered out of 75. I mean, these cards are just fantastic. Go through them real quick. So we got Hank Greenberg, Kirby Puckett. All these cards are like numbered to 100, both of those. A nice color match Pujols. There's a Biggio numbered out of 100. Nice Maguire insert. That one's not numbered out of 100, but a cool card. Beautiful Piazza refractor. God, look at that etching. In the Cage Sosa. Classic card there. Got this George Sisler, numbered out of 100. A nice... So this is one of the cards I bought from that table. So there was a young kid, had a table. I think he might have been a senior in high school. And we got to talking. And we just had a real nice conversation. And he ended up giving me a really good deal on the cards. And he thanked me for the conversation. He's like, I'm going to give you a good deal because I really enjoyed talking with you. Wish I remembered his name. Give him a shout out. I don't know if he's familiar with my channel, but we really did have a fun conversation. Really nice kid. God, this card I picked up for $4. I remember this card at one time was selling for over 100. So it's just amazing how things have changed in the hobby. Nice Maddox. I remember this card I had in my stack. I was going through a value box and there was a guy next to me and he kept eyeballing this card. I think he was upset that I found it before him. That's the way it goes in value boxes. So we got some Diamond Kings. All these are numbered under 100. That Zito is like numbered out of 25. I think this one, yeah, 50. So these are just cool cards. Just love that numbered stuff. I'm a sucker for numbered cards. More stuff. That's a cool Maguire. Look at that shine. Love the old refractors. Cecil Fielder, a.k.a. Big Daddy. Nice Power Brokers Piazza. Some rare JT Snows. Kind of a fan favorite in San Francisco. There's a gold SIG out of 100. A 99 Rave. Trout Sepia refractor. This card here, I got it for $5, this Beltron. It is numbered out of 5. So that's a really cool card. Guys, I had a good time, man. I just had a really good time at the show. I think that the less frequent I go to shows, the more fun I have. It's good to go to maybe 2 or 3 a year. I don't want to go to too many shows. This card I found in a value box for $1, this 97 Finest Refractor, a Barry Larkin. I mean, geez, can't go wrong for $1 on that card. So, some more cool inserts. Here we go with a Tech Color short print from 2000, a Maguire. Love those short prints. Artist Proof, Piazza, Maddox. That one's numbered out of 50. I thought this card was interesting. Got Satchel Paige with Milwaukee. And it turns out he was a coach with Milwaukee. Not a player, of course. But there we go. Cool card there. Numbered, I think it was out of 50. Yeah. Got a really nice card there. Nice prize collections. Maguire. Eric found this and let me buy it. He already had a copy, so he sent that my way. Nice Bobby Bonds. I always collect Bobby Bonds. And most of his good cards seem to be in a Giants uniform. This is another card I got from that young kid that had a table. This Jeter. Cool card there. Man, this card is really cool. I love how dirty the uniform is. Dress code, Ricky Henderson with the Padres. Just a great looking card. Dual relic. Gotta grab a Dave Stewart relic when I run into him. And this is a beautiful card here, a gold label Maguire. And then, so I saved the best for last, guys. This card, I couldn't walk away from. I pretty much was back and forth all day. And finally walked out of the show with this card. And anybody that knows anything about 90s cards can appreciate this, how rare this card is. And I'll explain what it is. It's 1998, Topps Stars and Steel, and this is the holographic gold. There is no record of one of these being sold online. I'm sure that there have been sales auctions, but maybe every time this particular card has been exchanged. It's been at a card show or privately. There's no record of one being sold online, whether it be ComC or eBay or 130 Point. There's just no record of it. But there we go, 1998. Stars in Steel, holographic gold Ken Griffey Jr. Man, I'm really glad. This is why I went way beyond my budget. My budget was $400. I ended up spending $1,000. This card was basically $600. I paid $600 for this card. And to be honest, I think I got a really, 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 really good price on this card. I certainly did not overpay. If anything, I mean, I didn't overpay at all. And I'm just thrilled to have it in my collection. So this is why I go to shows, guys, to find stuff like this, to find stuff that you can't find. You could have all the money in the world and you may never own this card. That's how tough it is to find. Whoa, thrilled to own it. Glad to show it off here. Glad to talk about it a little bit. Had a great time at the show. Appreciate everybody watching the recap. Comment down below. Let me know what you think. And as always, until next time, happy collecting!